Accessibility features usually fly under the radar in terms of product announcements, but are very often some of the coolest features on the iPhone. Here are the five awesome accessibility features coming this year in iOS 18. Let's start with number one, eye tracking. This advanced and highly ambitious feature lets you use your iPhone entirely with your eyes. Likely borrowing some tech from the Vision Pro, you could use this feature if you need to use your iPhone with soapy hands while you're doing the dishes, or dirty, oily hands while you're fixing your car. Enable it in Settings, Accessibility, Eye Tracking. Just like on the Vision Pro, you'll have to calibrate it by following a dot along on the screen. And then it'll work right away. Just glare at a button for a few moments to activate it. To activate controls like scrolling, volume, going to the home screen or control center, there's a floating on-screen button that you can, again, just look at. In my testing, the feature isn't super reliable, and that's understandable. The Vision Pro has multiple cameras less than an inch from your face. Your iPhone has one camera that you typically hold at arm's length away. The accuracy isn't going to be the same. For the best results, put your iPhone on a MagSafe stand, hold your face kind of close to it, and make sure there aren't a lot of reflections or glare on your glasses. Number two, music haptics add an extra dimension to your music. Taking advantage of the incredibly precise haptic engine built into your iPhone, music haptics are a specially recorded track of vibrations, buzzes, rhythms, and patterns timed to the music. Enable it in Settings, Accessibility, Music Haptics in the Hearing section. Currently, it's only available in Apple Music, which requires a subscription, but it may be added to your third-party app in the future. Not every song in the Apple Music catalog has it, but if it is available, you'll see a Music Haptics toggle under the Play Progress bar. I can't play music for you on YouTube, and I can't make you feel what it feels like, but this is a recording of what it's kind of like. Number three, vocal shortcuts let you set up your own audio cues, just like, but for running your own shortcuts automations. If you're not familiar with shortcuts, I made a quick explainer video here. This is a powerful way to automate your phone with only your voice. You don't have to make room for a widget on your home screen. You don't have to type in a shortcut with Spotlight or asking Siri. You don't have to dig through the Shortcuts app, God forbid. Set it up in Settings, Accessibility, Vocal Shortcuts in the Speech section towards the bottom. Enable Vocal Shortcuts, then tap Add Action to create one. Create a Siri request by entering in a command you often give to Siri, like text my partner I'm on my way home, play music by Driftless Pony Club, or roll a d20. Or you can pick a shortcut from any shortcut you have on your phone. Then you enter in the custom trigger phrase you want to use to run the action. It can be something as simple as stock update, or favorite music, or it can be something completely silly like ahoy computer. Then you'll need to speak it aloud three different times so that your phone can learn. At this step, I recommend going for different pitches in your voice, holding your phone at different distances from you, so that it can learn all the different ways you may speak it aloud. And that's all you need to do. Now you have a custom trigger phrase to run your favorite automation. Number four, if you get motion sick easily, you've probably had a hard time using your phone in a bumpy car ride. One solution is to get a car with expensive air ride suspension, but a much cheaper option is to enable vehicle motion cues in Settings, Accessibility, Motion, Show Vehicle Motion Cues. If you set it to automatic, it'll come on every time there's significant motion, and it'll go away when you're sitting still. The dots along the edge of the screen will animate to match the motion of the planes, trains, or automobiles you're riding. According to Apple, motion sickness is commonly caused by sensory conflict between what a person sees and what they feel. These dots will reduce the amount of sensory conflict so that you can read or watch TikTok on your long, windy car road trip without feeling ill. Number five, if you have a condition that affects your speech, Listen for Atypical speech might offer a big improvement on how features like Siri and dictation understand your voice. According to Apple, The feature will recognize user speech patterns on device, enhancing speech recognition for a wider range of speech. You can enable it in Settings, Accessibility, Siri, Listen for Atypical Speech. Just checking that feature might significantly improve the accuracy of your speech to text. And those are the 5 accessibility features. Remember to like and subscribe for more iOS 18 features. I'm D. Griffin Jones with Cult of Mac.